Good morning, children. Welcome back to the study module of social science. In the previous module, we have learned about Chapter 11, Part 1, National Movements of India from 1870s to 1947. As a continuation of this, in the second part, we are going to learn about different topics. Let us recapitulate a few of the topics we have learned so far. In the part one, we have learned about how different kinds of movements happen during the after the Battle of Plassey, and how India came in the hand of British, and different kinds of laws and different policies were introduced by the British, and how different Indians react on it, how the emergence of a big association or organization like Indian National Congress was happened, and how different ideologies among the leaders in the Indian National Congress itself creates to the split of Indian National Congress into two groups, as moderates and the extremists. We have learned about this topic so far in part one. Now let us start part two with the entry of our Papuji Mahatma Gandhi in the freedom movement of our country. Mahatma Gandhi, popularly known as Bapuji, he returned to India in 1915 after studying law in London and became a lawyer in South Africa at the age of 15. He returned to India in 1915, not this. And after this he returned, he spent almost 1 year traveling throughout India, interact with different people, and trying to find out their problems and feelings. And in 1916, he founded Sabarmati Ashram, and through this organization, he spread the ideology of truth and nonviolence in our society. As a part of this Sabarmati Ashram, spreading of truth and nonviolence, he helped the farmers of Bihar and led a movement called Champaran movement. This movement was specially led by Mahatma Gandhi to protest against the forced labor of forced farmer of Bihar, where farmers were forced by the British officials and their traders only to grow indigo. That's why many farmers faced problem of not getting proper food. So to get out of such kind of cruel act or activities of the British official, Mahatma Gandhi, along with the farmers of Bihar, started the Champaran movement in the year 1917. Again, he also fought against the famous or cruel act of the British, that is Rollat Act. According to this Rollat Act, the British authorized the government to imprison any person without any permission or trial from any court or magistrate, and due to this many Indians are suffer, because if the police suspect any person, then without any permission from the court, they used to arrest the Indians. That's why Mahatma Gandhi strongly opposed against such kind of cruel act of the British, and he encouraged that we should not depend on foreign goods, and due to this he encouraged Khadi to produce our own goods. So as a part of Rollat Act, British arrested two famous leaders called Dr. Saifuddin Kislew and Dr. Satyapal. Due to this, many protesters gathered in Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar, Punjab on 13th of April 1919. And they protested against the Rollat Act. So to suppress this kind of protesting or protest march, then a British officer called General Dyer bring thousands of soldiers, and he opened fire to the public, to the innocent people, and he killed thousands of people, including women and the children. So Jallianwala Bagh massacre was strongly opposed by many people of India and different leaders of India. Due to this Jallianwala Bagh massacre, Hindus and the Muslims became, and all other religions became united. Even Gandhi led strongly against this kind of incident, with the belief that India is for all people, the Hindus, the Muslims and all other religions living on this land are Indians. Like this, Mahatma Gandhi started opposing strongly against this kind of cruel incident. Now we are going to learn about Khilafat movement and non-cooperation movement. How Khilafat movement was started and how it was again connected to the non-cooperation movement. The British and France divided the Ottoman Empire. Ottoman Empire, which we call as Turkey now, and they removed the post of Caliphate. The Caliphate was the religious, what we call as title or leader of the Muslim community. So they, after Ottoman Empire was divided among Britain and France, the title and the status of Caliphate was abolished, that means lost. So this kind of things was considered as an insult by the Indian Muslim. So the two Muslim brothers of India, it is Ali brothers, popularly known as Ali brothers. Ali brothers, they are Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. They started a movement against this act of the British and the France, that is removing of the title of Caliphate and status of Caliphate. So they held a conference in 1919 and they decided that we are going to protest against the removal of status of Caliphate throughout India. There is countrywide agitation is going to start. So such kind of countrywide agitation was again supported by Indian National Congress under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi and Muslim League under the leadership of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. And so after this Caliphate movement, Gandhi announced non-cooperation movement, and under this non-cooperation movement he demanded that Khilafat movement should be solved. The Khilafat movement should be solved and the cruel act, that is Rowlatt Act, should be removed from our country. As a part of non-cooperation movement under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, many people started to boycott schools, colleges, law courts, and they also give up foreign goods. Women, many women, children and people participated in this movement, and the non-cooperation movement was widely spread throughout India. Now we are going to discuss about Chauri Chaura incident. So what is Chauri Chaura incident and why it is considered as one of the most important incident in the history of India? Chauri Chaura is a village in Gorakhpur, UP, Uttar Pradesh state, and this incident was happened in February 1922. And what is the incident? There is the incident of violence from Mahatma Gandhi to withdraw the movement. What movement? Non-cooperation movement. And this incident was happened when 3,000 farmers at Chauri Chaura village were fired by the police. So the angry farmers again attacked to the police, and they burned the police station. Due to this, 22 policemen were dead. So that means Mahatma Gandhi tried to promote truth and non-violence. That means Mahatma Gandhi tried to promote non-violence, that is we should not use any kind of violence during our protest march. But here 22 police were dead, that means violence was happened from the side of protesters. That's why Mahatma Gandhi immediately called off the non-cooperation movement. So after the non-cooperation movement was called off, many Indian leaders started to enter in the political activity, like C.R. Das and Motilal Nehru. They entered in the political activity, they formed Swaraj Party, and they won seats in the election of 1923 assembly election. And many Indian leaders like Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel still continue nationalist programs by opening schools and promoting Hindu Muslim unity in our Indian society. That means even after the non-cooperation movement was called off, the nationalist activities was not stopped and it was continued by different leaders of our country. And during this period, different revolutionary movement was also started, like the Hindustan Republican Association, HRA, was formed, and it was mainly formed in to begin an armed revolution in the year 1924. In 1925, a commission was sent to India. In 1928, a commission was sent to India by the British government to suggest the constitutional reforms in India. That means what constitutional changes should be made in India to suggest the constitutional reforms in India. The Simon Commission was sent by the British government. But one more interesting thing is that the people who are a part of Simon Commission was totally British. There were no Indians present in the Simon Commission. So the people of India strongly protest against the Simon Commission, and they even shout the slogans like Simon go back. They even shout the slogans like Simon go back. And as a part of this protest, Lala Lajpat Rai was killed during the lathi charge by the police. So Bhagat Singh and Rajguru take it very seriously, and they responded to the brutal killing of Lala Lajpat Rai by throwing bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly. Due to this, after that they were caught, and Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru were hanged in public, and Chandrasekhar Azad also attacked the police, and he killed some police officers, and he was died in a police encounter. And another incident happened during the 1920s was the emergence of Communist Party in India, which was inspired by Marxist, that is originated from Russia, and the birth of RSS, that is Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, or Hindu organization which is in favor of the cause of Hindu. And Congress in the Lahore session of 1929, a resolution was passed which declared Purna Swaraj. Purna Swaraj means complete or full independence.
So on 31st December 1929, a newly adopted tricolor flag was hoisted and declared as a national flag. So on 26th January 1930, was declared as the first independence of India, first independence day of India. Remember the date and the year. 26th January 1930 was declared as the first independence of India, and our tricolor national flag was first hoisted on 31st December 1929, and it was adopted as the national flag of our country. And later on, after the announcement of first independence day, the Congress also announced and launched a new movement called civil disobedience movement on this day. And next, in civil disobedience movement and the Dandi March, we are going to discuss in the next module, because this video is becoming a little bit big. That's why let's discuss civil disobedience movement and Dandi March in the next video. Thank you for watching. Please comment if there is any doubt. Stay home and stay safe.